Dear students, welcome to online classes. Today we are going to discuss about the topic scattering of light from human eye and colorful world of 10th class physics. It is our common experience that the sky appears blue in color on a bright dry day. So why is the sky blue? To answer this question, you need to understand another phenomenon of light called scattering. So, what is scattering? Let us see. So, scattering of light is a complex phenomenon to understand. So, let us try to understand with a simple experiments. So, do you know what happens to the free atom or a molecule when it is exposed to certain frequency of light? Let it be an atom and let it be some energy, light energy. So when it is exposed, it should respond. Okay, na? So let us see how it responds. Let us consider that the free atom or free molecule is somewhere in the space. Light of certain frequency falls on that atom or the molecule. So this atom or molecule should respond to the light whenever the size of the atom or the molecule is comparable to the wavelength of the light. If this condition is satisfied, the atom absorbs light and vibrates. Due to these vibrations, the atom re-emits a certain frequency of light energy, means which is a fraction of absorbed energy, in all directions with different intensities. The re-emitted light is called scattered light. So the process of re-emission of light in all directions with different intensities is called scattering of light. The atoms or molecules are called scattering centers. Let us take the angle theta between the incident light and the direction in which the intensity of scattered light is observed. We call this angle as angle of scattering. So it is experimentally observed that the intensity of scattered light varies with the angle of scattering. The intensity is maximum at 90 degrees angle of scattering. Let it be an atom. Atom is spherical and some rotation, electron rotation is happening inside. So let it be an atom. Let an emission, electromagnetic wave or some radiation of certain frequency is incident on the atom, so that the wavelength of this radiation and the size of the atom are comparable in this condition. Then what happened? Yes, it is absorbed by the atom and it will re-emit the light radiations with different frequencies. Now you can observe this here, red, green and blue light waves with different wavelengths and frequencies are emitted. So emit some part of the light energy that is absorbed previously in different directions. The process of re-emission of light in all directions with different intensity is called scattering of light. This is the basic process happens in scattering of light. The effect of the light on a molecule or an atom depends on the size of the atom or molecule. So these are the different sizes of the atom. H means hydrogen atom, N means nitrogen, I means iodine. So every atom has its own size. If the size of the particle is small, it will be affected by higher frequencies. Higher frequency light and vice versa. So these are the different frequencies and wavelengths of the a visible light region, VIBGR, violet, blue, green, yellow, orange, red. Now, if the wavelength is matched to the size, then automatically they will absorb that light and they will re-emit. Means scattering happens in this condition. This is the reason for the appearance of clear blue color when look at the sky in a direction perpendicular to the direction of the sun rays. So that is why the blue color of the sky appears. If our angle of view is changed, the intensity of blue color also changes. Now you might have got a doubt, why scattering of light gives only blue color? Why can't it give other? So let us find out whether the scattering centers are responsible for the blue color of the sky. So we know that our entire atmosphere contains different types of molecules and atoms. The reason for blue sky is due to the molecules of nitrogen and oxygen, N2 and O2. The sizes of these molecules are comparable to the wavelength of the blue light, and these molecules act as scattering centers for scattering of the blue light. So, hence, blue light will appear. So why is that the sky appears white sometimes when you view it in certain direction or hot days? Our atmosphere contains atoms and molecules of different sizes. According to their sizes, they are able to scatter different wavelengths of light. For example, the size of the water molecule is greater than the size of the nitrogen and oxygen. It acts as a scattering center for the other colored lights. So means other frequencies which are lower than the frequency of blue light. So they are nothing but, yes, on a hot day due to rise in the temperature, water vapor enters into atmosphere, which leads to abundant presence of water molecules in the atmosphere. These water molecules scatter the color of other frequencies, means which are other than blue. All such colors of other frequencies reach your eye and sky appears as white. So that is why clouds always appears white in color, because clouds contain water molecules only. So that, do you know the reasons for appearance of the red color of the sky during sunrise and sunset? Like this, the atmosphere contains free molecules and atoms with different sizes. Same point is repeating here. These molecules and atoms scatter light of different wavelengths which are comparable to their sizes. Molecules having a size that is comparable to the wavelength of the red light are less in the atmosphere. Hence, the scattering of red light is less when compared to the other colors of the light. The light from the sun needs to travel more distance in atmosphere during sunrise and sunset to reach our eye. So, in morning and evening times, during sunrise and sunset, except red light, all colors scatter more and vanish before they reach our eye. Since the scattering of red light is very small, it reaches you. So as a result, sun appears red in color during sunrise and sunset. So can you guess the reason why sun does not appear red during noon hours? Yes, during noon hours, the distance to be traveled by the sun rays in the atmosphere is less than that compared to the morning and evening. Therefore, all colors reach your eye without much scattering. Hence, the sun appears white during noons.